From Amateur Radio Newsline Report number 2279, this is Ham Nation Headlines for Wednesday, July 7th, 2021. Our top story this week comes from Australia, where hams have been waiting for official word on their request to get 2x1 contest call signs.
The Australian Communications and Media Authority has advised amateurs that it'll be approving the use of 2x1 call signs for contesting shortly. The ACMA said in its June 29th e-bulletin that it's working out how the call signs will be issued. The new call signs will be implemented by the Australian Maritime College. The 2x1 call signs are to be restricted to use specifically during local and international contests and may only be issued to advanced class licence holders. There were no further details on the timetable nor on the specifics of the implementation. Meanwhile, the AMC has advised amateurs that while a call sign application system is being finalised, no one is to apply for any 2x1 call signs, since none's available yet and the correct application system is not yet live. Any hams who have mistakenly applied for the 2x1 call signs will have their monies refunded. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm John Williams, VK4JJW.
The popular small satellites known as CubeSats will soon have another avenue into the sky.
CubeSats, and more CubeSats. That's what is on the agenda for Launcher, a space startup that hopes to carry stacks of CubeSats skyward next year using a satellite platform known as Orbiter, which has a maximum carrying capacity of 330 pounds or 150 kilograms. According to an announcement made by the California-based company, Orbiter will be used first for rideshare missions and will be launched on a SpaceX rocket. The company said Orbiter has a contract with SpaceX to fly in October of 2022. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Stephen Kinford, NAWB.
Remember the excitement over that first day at camp? Well, it's about to happen for some young radio operators at the first camp of its kind in this part of the world.
Camp is in session in just another week or so for young amateur radio operators. But this isn't just any camp. It's the first of its kind for young radio operators ages 15 to 25 in North Central and South America. The Youth on the Air Camp in the Americas will take place from Sunday, July 11th to Friday, July 16th at the National Voice of America Museum of Broadcasting near Cincinnati, Ohio. The highlights of the week include a scheduled contact with an astronaut aboard the International Space Station through the ARIS program and a week-long special event station W8Y, which will be operating on HFN satellite. Even if you're no longer a young radio operator or your QTH is outside the U.S., you can still be part of some of the camp's activities. The Youth on the Air YouTube channel will be streaming the ARIS contact live and will also carry the opening and closing ceremonies live. The keynote speaker for Sunday's opening ceremony is Tim Duffy, K3LR. The camp's director is Amateur Radio Newsline's own Neil Rapp, WB9VPG. The ARIS contact will take place either Wednesday, July 14th or Thursday, July 15th. For additional details, visit the website at youthontheair.org. We here at Newsline wish Neil and the campers all the best, great times, and great contacts. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Dave Parks, WB8ODF.
And that's all from the Amateur Radio Newsline, your independent source for amateur radio news for four decades and counting at arnewsline.org. With John Williams, VK4JJW, Stephen Kinford, NAWB, Dave Parks, WB8ODF, Karen Eve Murray, KD2GUT at the news desk in New York, and our news team across the globe, I'm Don Wellbanks, AE5DW73. We'll see you next time here on Ham Nation.